Father, always continue to be with us. May we be obedient to your word, Father. Amen. Because not everybody can go. You know, it's so tall, you know, it's not even get medical conditions. Amen. And it's important that you fast, that you consult your medical doctor. Find out how many you know about fasting. And you know all the time that you should have been fasting. But not just fasting the church in church to fast. God needs to find the spirit to fast. Fasting to be a part of your life as a believer. The church, the early church fasting. Amen. Even today you still fast. Hallelujah. So, up to you when you go half a day, or you can go full day, it's up to you. You with me? The important thing is that it's fasting, that it's about you and God. You can choose, for example, to maybe skip a meal. And instead of eating the meal, you take your Bible and you spend time with God, you eat the Word, you spend time praying, is that going to be your eating time? And then, that meal that you were supposed to have eaten, give it to somebody who doesn't have something to eat. Come on, we're not getting it. That means that you would have eaten, given to somebody who does not care about you. You know, you can use gospel churches. Jesus spoke about giving of alms. He says, when you give your alms, do it in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly. He says, don't be like the hypocrites. Ask them how to perform that you give it. As a church, we partner with organizations that help the less fortunate and the destitute in our community. You'll never find us taking photos of things we are giving away and posting on our social media. We don't do it. We're posted on the church group to let everybody know that we're listening to a part of this. From time to time, we're posted on the church group and say, this is where we want to go. But we will not broadcast it because then we do not receive the reward of alms giving. You get that? It's a secret. It's between you and God. Hallelujah. It speaks about when you give your alms. Do it in secret. And then it speaks about when you pray. In the same gospel of Matthew 6, it says when you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, stand in the corner, thinking, pray on false words to be heard by people that you pray. But when you pray, go to your closet. Come on, somebody. Go into your closet and pray to your Father in secret. And your Father in secret will be what you open. Then he says, from verse 16, he's speaking about the Lord of the from verse 15, 16, 17, 18. He says, you when you fast, do not be like the hypocrites. So in other words, you can fast the right way, and the fasting is the wrong way. Even so, there is pray the right way and pray the wrong way. There's giving of alms the wrong way and giving of alms the right way. Hallelujah. He says, how do the hypocrites fast? He says this. They go around by sects. They want them to appear to men that they are fasting. You get people there when they go on a fast. God forbid that they don't preach. You know, look at this and make this competition. You know, you hear people, our church is fasting for 3 days, our church is fasting for 7 days, our church is fasting for 21 days, our church is fasting for 40 days. Hey, it's not a competition. The thing is, you can fast for 40 days and still get no results. The length of time of fasting is still there. It's the quality that matters. There must be results. Someone who
The mind and the body have to be subjected to the spirit.
For what reveals with those two barriers? The barrier of the mind. Because the mind cannot be seen from God. Because the mind is invisible to us. Isaiah says, your thoughts are not my thoughts. And your ways are not my ways. As high as the heavens are above me, and so far from my thoughts to me, are my thoughts higher than yours. To look through you, you'll see things the way God sees them. You'll hear things the way God has called to be someone. You'll understand what God is saying. You'll know this. And you know, this is just not doing things God's way to go. The Bible says there's a way.
Go shout on the rooftops.
central protection, symbolic of mourning. Why are we in church?
Omnipotent, is all powerful, and is unchanging.
If something is wrong, it's wrong. Fasting will never change. When you look at 1 Samuel chapter number 12, David, find David, go, he commits adultery, and a child is born. The child is born, and God's righteous judgment is that that child will die. And David goes on a 7-day fast. He fasted 7 days, the number of perfection, seven perfected days. David fasted, the child still dies. Because of the righteous requirement of God. When we do something wrong, fasting will not change God's mind. Nothing will. But go with a repentant heart before the Lord. Repentance to turn away from return. It's repentance. And it is not just saying, Lord, I'm sorry, but it is genuine repentance. Because you can say, I'm sorry, but you still keep on doing the same thing. That means you have to be repentant. The Bible says, godly sorrow produces repentance. Godly sorrow. So fasting will never change the righteous judgments of God. Hallelujah. I said to you, you've got to prepare yourself for the fast. Prepare yourself. Tell the people, prepare yourself. You've got to be prepared. So how long is not important? Where is half a day, 1 day, 3 days, 7 days, 21 days, 40 days? There must be a change in you. There has to be a change. So when you prepare to fast, you must have an attitude of faith. It's an attitude of faith. Believing that it is God's will for you to fast. You must believe. Let's go to Matthew chapter 6. I just hope that something is wrong here. Matthew chapter 6. Hallelujah. Thank you. Matthew 6 verse 16. Jesus says, moreover, when you fast, do not be like the hypocrites who say compliments. When Jesus says, when you fast, means there's a time you must fast. He didn't say if you fast. He said when you fast. When means there's an action that is. There's an action that's required. What's required? Fasting. He says, don't be like the hypocrites who serve companies. For they disfigure their faces that they may appear to men to be fasting. But surely I say, but when you fast, and this is what you're going to do for the next 21 days, beginning tomorrow morning, you're going to anoint your head and wash your face so that you do not appear to men to be fasting, but to your Father who is in the secret place. You who arise in the secret place of your life, come and talk to me. You arise in the secret place of the Most High, the light and the shadow of the Almighty. I will say unto the Lord, come and talk to me, somebody. But your Father will see the secret. And your Father will see the secret. 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 Will do what? Will reward you for it. Hebrews tells us, without faith it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that he is, must believe that he exists. And that he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. Isaiah tells us, seek the Lord while he may be found. Seek him. Seek his face. Hallelujah. Seek him. So this is the attitude. This is the attitude. A positive attitude of faith, believing that it is God's will for me to pass, because it's His way to pass. And then He gave me specific instructions, what I ought to do. And not only that, He will reward me. You must believe this. God will reward you. There's nothing that you can give up for God that God will restore to you even more than what you gave up. That's this life we have. Hallelujah. So when you fast the right way with the right motives, God will reward you openly. And here's the thing, if you fail to fast, you are actually depriving yourself of the reward. Because God can't reward you if you don't meet these conditions. So you've got to fast the right way. Now the reward may be different to what you expect from God, but nonetheless it will be God's reward, and nothing can be more beneficial to you and I than having God's reward. You may be expecting a certain, you know, it must happen a certain way for God to do it, when in a way that will blow your mind. It never happens the way you expect it. I'm always humble to God. He'll always reward. When you're seeking, you are finding and you're rewarding, but it's His reward. I don't care what it is, but as long as it comes from Him, I am grateful for that. I'm thankful. Amen. I share with you also about knowing your body. I mean, you should know what you can get, whether you know some people cannot fast because of medical conditions. Last thing I want is people who have to fast. Oh, you know, Pastor, you can't do that. You want to fast in church, you want to fast. Then the person gets sick and ends up in the hospital. And now the family is trying to go to the pastor. And you find the whole community. Hey, check. The pastor is going to be better than the pastor. Know what you want to get there. It's an important thing. It's at that time. Spend time with God. You can choose. You can be great. You can be not. You can say, I'm going to spend time. The quality that comes out of the commandments. You know what makes me sick? And don't let me find that in you. If I walk in the town and you disfigure yourself, the next thing you want to do is sad. You know, you really want to make it really hard. People need to know how to. You know, people are saying, how can you find that in your own? Listen, I'm a pastor. I see. I can't keep you there. I'll tell you, I'll take you by the hand, I'll grab you, I'll take you to the nearest food place and say, just order something to eat, please. Don't be a sad person for God. Really, eat, don't eat. Then you sad and depressed and cry, you know, God is so bad, it's punishing you, I mustn't eat. Why are you eating? Because you're giving the wrong place. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. faz uma dimensão, uma outra dimensão para ele.
Amém.
Amém. You are free by the Spirit, you are full of the Spirit. let's go back to the next gospel, chapter 4. I want to show you something. Luke's Gospel, chapter 4. Verse 1. Then Jesus, being filled with the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan when he was baptized with John, and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being tempted for 40 days by the devil. And in those days, he ate nothing. And afterwards, when he had ended, he was hungry. Now pay attention to verse number 14. Verse 1 says, he was full with the Spirit, and he was led by the Spirit to fast. Verse 14 says, this is after he has fasted, then Jesus returned to the power of the Spirit. You see, then he returned to the power of the Spirit of Galilee. See that? So fasting is an empowering event. It's an empowering experience. Your spirit and your he gets empowerment from God. Hallelujah. The sixth purpose of fasting is to get God's intervention in times of crisis, or when some tremendous problem arises that you can't handle by ordinary means. Things that you can't handle by ordinary means. Hallelujah. If you remember Mordecai, how Mordecai when they fasted because of what was happening. So it was beyond their control, so they fasted. So it is things that are just beyond your control that you cannot handle ordinarily. Because you see God's intervention. Amen? So fasting actually available, fasting makes available to you extraordinary resources to overcome challenges in your life. That's what fasting does. It develops extraordinary resources to you. And last is to intercede and pray on behalf of others. When you intercede and pray on behalf of someone else, in other words, are you willing to do something that will cost you on behalf of your loved one? Sometimes it could be for the salvation of a loved one. It could be for the healing of a loved one. It's when you intercede on someone else's behalf. You fast and pray. Amen. So just some practical things that you can consider in your fasting, I told you. Number one is to take extra time for reading the Bible and prayer. Take extra time. Take extra time. You see, Bible reading should be of paramount importance before you pray. Did you know when you read the Word of God, the Word of God anoints your spirit. And when you pray anointed things. Because now you pray in accordance with His Word. And His Word is His Word. When you read the Bible, if ever you want to, you know, you have people who are much more important, you spend time in the Bible. The Word of God anoints your spirit. The spirit starts getting cold. You know, things happen. I can't describe this thing to you. You've got experience in yourself. And it's true. So when Bible reading is first, it comes first, your spirit gets anointed, and your mind falls in line with God's word. Falls in line with God. And then now your prayer will be more effective after reading the Bible. And secondly, you must watch against spiritual attack. You must watch against it. You must expect it. You know the religious goal of fasting is that when you're fasting, some people say, oh, you know, people are coming with just so that you can carry the fasting. No, don't carry the fasting because you lose your reward. He said, thank you, but I'm not hungry. They might say, no, how are you not doing fasting? Say, no, thank you. It's okay, I've eaten. You know, I'm not eating. No, thank you. You must be on your guard. Because, listen, not eating is not the real sacrifice. That's not the real sacrifice. The real sacrifice, the real thing that matters, what really matters, is that when you decide to fast and pray, Satan will use every resource he has available to come. You must expect that. You lose more demons. You'll find you go to pee at some time, you start feeling the dopamine. Things that you wouldn't normally feel in a normal life. Lonely, sad. You know, all those things. And when those things are happening, you say, Satan, in the name of Jesus. You understand? In the name of Jesus. You understand what I'm saying? Every time the enemy is trying to bring something your way, you want to clap and praise God because it means that you can get something out of this. And Satan doesn't want you to have it. Hallelujah. So don't get worried. Hallelujah. In fact, it's a backhand compliment from the devil saying you are the right ones. Hallelujah. So don't let your feelings protect you. Just bear in mind the basic truths that God is with you, that God loves you, and that God is a rewarder of those who seek Him. And lastly, don't put on a religious act. Don't let anybody go to fasting. But then, what do you want to do? You see, because once you tell someone to fast, you've already received your report. That person says, wow, I'm fasting. That's your report. Don't do it anymore. Wash your face. You put secret. It's business as usual. Some people, because they're fasting, it means now they can't come out for their own. They can't leave the house for their own. They can't do certain things. Even at work, they say they can't do certain things. Some people want to take leave, go, fast, not listen, eat. Man, just carry on. Nobody can go fast. And you'll see at the end of those 21 days. The title of our message is Fasting, Prayer, and Praise.
You are having fun, but man, you are having fun.
Here to tell you this morning, expect to see His glory. Expect to see His glory.
Yeshua, the Messiah, His name.
And if you can, make it for me or for whatever touches your heart, focus on those. Amen. Those who pray for you, I encourage you to anoint the pot of you can take any oil. Look, you can take any oil. And anoint your head. Anoint your head. Last time you were in your seat, you can go to the cloud and get anointed. We were singing that song further down on the ground of the world. You understand? We can only feel something that's in you. And when you fast, you can get to yourself of the flesh. And when you take the oil, this is what you say, I'll anoint my head with oil and I'll chop part of the oil. You understand? You're confessing that, that you're living a life of overflow. You're anointing my head with oil and I'll chop part of the oil. Say, Father, I thank you, my God, come to you. So every morning, anoint your head with oil, go about your way. Because when you do the anointing of the oil, what it is doing is, means I'm consecrating myself for holy service. Yet, I'm setting myself apart. That's my cross. Understand? And Jesus says, you know, you that's my closet. Because, hey, listen, a closet, there's no water that's leaking out of here. Am I saying that there's so many closets? No. What I'm saying is that I have someone so great in me, there's no water that can contain the four of us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit in me. Understand, it's not because of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And don't be shy at 21 years. Don't be shy. Play big tennis. Tell yourself, stop being small players. Don't be small. Stop a big car. I'm going to ask you and I'm going to see people. I mean, you trust God. Man, you're trusting God just to take the things. When God can make you own the house. You want you to be the home. You're trusting God just for passing through it. God can finance a miracle for you. You don't have to write like this. You write for yourself. I mean, maybe you can trust God.